Good morning, friends. This is the third lecture of business communication. In the last lecture, that is in the lecture two, we have discussed about the objectives of communication. Now, in this lecture, we will be covering about the need, role, and importance of the communication along with the organizational communication, the different forms of organizational communication. So here we go. Coming down to the need of communication, the need for the reasons for the growing importance of communication in modern organization may be summarized as under. Number one, giant organizations. Modern organizations have grown in size to a great extent and employing a large number of people to achieve their objectives. They have complicated these structures with several layers of management. Effective coordination can be achieved only when the communication is effective. That is the reason effective system of communication is very much desired in this context. The second point, global business environment. Many organizations operate at the transnational level. Naturally, communication is to be given greater attention for success in international business. The third point, technological advancements. The modern era is characterized by rapid changes in the technology. But application of new technology is not an easy task because of the resistance offered by the workforce. Whenever you try to adopt some new technology in your organization, it is most likely that you will be facing resistance on part of your workers to accept that technology. Only an effective system of communication can help the management to overcome such kind of resistance to change on the part of workforce. Management can keep workforce fully informed about the latest development and can educate them about the usage of new development. Here, these few points can be taken care of. Number one, timely information. Modern organizations need adequate and timely information for better decision making. To keep the workforce informed and also to view better human relation, the nature of employment relationship has changed from master relationship, from partnership relationship. The employees are the stakeholders and they contribute to the prosperity of the employees. No management can manage effectively if does not understand the need, perception, and feelings of the employees. Better public relations. An industrial enterprise works in the society and so it has got certain social obligations towards the customers, workers, governments, suppliers, and the general public. Now, coming down to the role and importance of communication. According to Henry Mintzberg, managers have to perform three major roles. Interpersonal, number one, number two, informational, number three, decisional. Communication helps the managers in performing each of these roles effectively. In interpersonal roles, managers interact with their superiors, peers, and subordinates. In informational roles, they receive and give information to people inside and outside the organization. And in the decisional roles, they take important decisions in communicate them to the organizational members for their effective implementation. Several studies have revealed that most of the managers are spending 3/4 of their timing in communicating with others. Through communication, the manager informs the employees what they have to do and how the work has to be done. The importance of internal communication can be better understood from the points that we are going to discuss now. Number one, facilitates planning. Communication facilitates the planning in a number of ways. Participation of executives in planning is a precondition for getting the task done. This can be secured only through interaction and communication. Further, to be realistic, planning should be based on accurate information. Such information can be available only when there is a systematic communication in the enterprise. The entire plan will fail if the information regarding the latest market development is not available to the planner. Second point, basis for decision making. Communication helps the manager in arriving at vital decisions. If the right type of information is not available at the proper time due to lack of communication, it may not be possible for the management to consider all the pros and cons before taking a decision. Moreover, it is through communication that management comes closer to the subordinates and is able to identify the real problems and take appropriate decisions. Thus, communication is essential for decision making. Third point, achieves effective coordination. Communication helps in synchronizing the activities of different individuals and groups to bring about unity of action. Liaison men who are employed to coordinate work of different individuals in the organizations need to evolve communication between different parts of the organizations. Group meetings is a means of coordination which necessarily involves exchange of ideas and knowledge and transfer of information and understanding with each other. Fourth point, facilitates better administration. Communication is important in the performance of all the managerial functions. Planning, which is one of the primary managerial functions, requires detailed communication among the managerial and other personnel. Moreover, effective communication is important in executing the plans and then controlling the activities with the help of feedback information. Information about the subordinates' performance is necessary to determine whether the planned objectives are being realized or not. Communication is an important date in directing and motivating the employees in an organization. Thus, communication is an indispensable part of the management process. Fifth point, creation of mutual trust and confidence. An effective communication system helps the manager to convey his ideas, views, decisions, suggestions and feelings to the employees. On the other hand, the employees also get opportunity to express their feelings and communicate their ideas and reactions to the managers. Thus, Effective communication builds an atmosphere of mutual trust and confidence in the enterprise. Sixth point, motivation of employees. Motivation of employees largely depends upon the effectiveness of the communication. Sharing of the information with the employees help the management to secure their willing cooperation. Discussions on the matters of common concern between the managers and the employees is a source of satisfaction for the employees, and it signifies the recognition of their importance. Information sharing and consultation act strongly motivate the employees, and thus it is a strong motivation factors for the employees. Now, seventh point is building employee morale. Communication in industry is the basis for morale building. Under an effective system of communication, it is quite convenient for the employees to bring their grievances to the notice of the management and get a proper adjustment. It creates mutual trust and faith, and ultimately ensures job satisfaction among the employees, creates confidence and the ability of the managers in promoting their loyalty towards the enterprise. It satisfies their personal and social needs and stimulates their job interest and enthusiasm. Grievances get suppressed, and lack of communication will not have any effect in such a situation. 8. Binding force or commitment. Effective communication induces the human resources in the organization to develop a spirit of cooperation and produces a positive energy to do the work. In this way, effective communication binds them together and creates a spirit of commitment among them. 9. Facilitates effective control. Controlling is an important aspect of managing. It helps the managers to measure the and evaluate the performance of their subordinates and provides them with feedback on their performance. Communication helps in controlling by transmitting information about the performance of the subordinates to the managers. If the information received by the manager reveals that the performance of the subordinate is not up to the mark, he can take corrective actions immediately. Now, coming down to the next topic, which is organizational communication. Organizational communication may be divided into two types: internal communication and external communication. The first is the internal communication, the second one is the external communication. Now, coming down to the internal communication. Internal communication, what is internal communication? When people within the organization communicate with each other, it is known as internal communication. They do so to work as a team and realize the common goals. It could be official, it could be unofficial. It could be individual to individual, individual to group, group to individual, department to department, etc. Much of internal communication may be in the oral form and the tone may be informal. People also communicate within the organization at a personal level. This is called informal communication. A good example of informal communication is that of a grapevine, which is present in some or the other form everywhere. If the atmosphere is secretive, it encourages the spread of rumors also. Intelligent managers use this human weakness to their advantage by sharing favorable information with the employees so that the same may get transmitted through grapevine also. Modes of internal communication includes face-to-face communication as well as written communication. Some of the common modes of written communication are memos, reports, office orders, circulars, staff newsletters, emails, fax, notices, agendas, notes on agendas, minutes of meeting, manuals, etc. Various modes of non-verbal communication may also be used in internal communication. Now coming down to the second form of communication, which is external communication. When people in the organization communicate with anyone outside the organization, such a form of communication is known as external communication. The outsiders may be clients, customers, dealers, distributors, media, government, suppliers, general public, regulatory bodies, authorities, etc. Letters and circulars, price lists, manuals, purchase orders, customized reports, brochures, and service calls, tender documents and advertisements, customer feedback materials, all are classified as external communication. Modern business houses spend considerable time, money and effort on improving their public image since they have realized that they are dependent on external support. External communication has been namely formal and largely documented, but there is an increasing trend to make it informal. Some of the modes of formal communication that may be used are circulars, graph charts, emails, fax, forms, questionnaire letters, advertisements, customer newsletters, press releases, invitations, leaflets, brochures, handbills, manuals, telegrams, etc. So friends, this is all about role and importance of communication. Very soon we will be meeting with the lecture 4 of business communication. Till then, thank you very much.